What's going on, y'all, man? It's official Drake Live, bruh. Feel me? Back at y'all with another reaction video from the man himself, Mike Korzemba. You feel me? Subscribe to the channel if you're new. Turn on notifications, man. Also, comment down below a way I can improve on my channel. You feel me, dog? Now, this is why the Warriors know Nico was still in the draft. Feel me? I heard he slipped in the draft. Not going to cap to you. I heard he slipped bad in the draft. Anyways, man, this is a Mike Korzemba reaction. Love his videos. Links to everything down in the description. Without further ado, man, let's get on with the video.
Nico Mannion before last season, you would think this kid was headed for a great NBA career. He was even possibly going to develop into an all-star level talent. And these were not crazy thoughts to have. He also was the feature of a Sports Illustrated article when he was just 15 years old that called him a sorta maybe basketball prodigy. And from there, Nico became a sorta maybe mixtape legend. His highlights were all over YouTube and Instagram. He racked up millions and millions of views. And while the hype was high, it also looked very real. Because by the time he finished high school, Nico was ranked as the 9th rated player in his class according to ESPN and headed into college in September of 2019. ESPN had Nico projected as the number 8 pick in the 2020 draft, while Yahoo and CBS had him going 7th. But then, after a season at Arizona that many saw as a disappointment, Nico fell all the way to the second round of the 2020 draft, and many wondered what exactly happened here. Why did a top 10 high school prospect and a top 10 projected NBA pick before the season suddenly fall off of everyone's radar? Well, guys, that's what we're going to look at in today's video, and we're also going to figure out if Nico Mannion can rebound and become a true steal of this year's NBA draft. So what's up, guys? Mike here, and the reason we are talking about Nico Mannion today is that we have talked about him before. I do really like checking up on guys we have talked about, especially young prospects. And I've got to say, due to some recent articles that have come out and some recent video of Nico's play, my interest has been piqued because a lot of big time people have said a lot of great things about Nico's game recently. And when we look at this footage here, we can see that in a recent run against professional basketball players, Nico dominated. Yes, in this video posted by Ball Is Life, Nico certainly turned some heads, and the first thing that stands out to me is that Nico definitely added some muscle to his frame. Now, we'll get into Nico's personal statements on his improvements in a bit, but just know that he has said that he's added about 12 to 15 pounds in the offseason, and I don't think that's an exaggeration at all, which is really great for him because this added weight seems like it could be huge. Playing for Arizona, Nico often struggled to finish around the rim consistently, but as we see in this video, he is doing just that. He is straight up bodying people at times, and that, combined with his incredible court vision and shooting ability, already makes him a much improved NBA prospect in my eyes. This video did pop up for me on YouTube, and it was what got me interested in Nico. What kept me interested, though, is what I found out after I researched him. Because after I did some digging with the background knowledge I already had about Nico in mind, I have come to this conclusion. And guys, before we continue, I'm excited to thank Geology for sponsoring today's video. Now, if you didn't know, Geology is a personalized skincare brand for men. Yep. Nourishing.
We come here to react. We come here to react.
Go check out.
We come here to react.
In conversations with NBA execs this morning, how in the world did Nico Mannion drop all the way to 48? What a great pick for Golden State. Call me crazy, but he could very well contribute this year. Two-way or not, I love his fit in Kerr's offense. Now, you may be questioning this statement because if it was true, why wouldn't the teams that were surprised Nico fell so far just go out and draft him? Well, there is a simple answer to that question, and it's that Nico wanted to play for the Warriors, and the Warriors wanted him, and so, once it became the second round and guaranteed contracts went out the window, it's been reported that teams did show interest in drafting Nico, but he told them he was not interested. That is a very bold move for a second rounder, but that also tells me that Nico is betting on himself. And I think he has good reason to. Before we get into that, though, I want to talk about what went wrong here. Why did Nico fall all the way from a top 10 prospect to the number 48 pick in the draft? Obviously, something had to have gone wrong. Well, for starters here, many mock drafts did have Nico going in the late first round, which means the Warriors already got a pretty good value pick at 48. Golden State certainly agreed with this, as general manager Bob Myers stated, "We had him higher than 48. 38 for sure. As for why Nico was only ranked as a late first round pick, at Arizona, it became apparent that it was hard for Nico to create his own shot due to his size and weight. He also struggled in the half court as he looked much more comfortable playing in transition, and he shot the ball poorly. Headed into college, Nico's shooting was what made him a complete offensive weapon. Because he was a knockdown three-point shooter, opponents had to respect his jump shot, and this allowed him to explode past defenders and get to the rim with ease. However, once he entered college, again, Nico struggled when shooting the basketball and finished the year with just a 39% field goal percentage and a 33% three-point percentage. Luckily, though, if you are a Warriors fan or a fan of Nico himself, it appears that many of the problems that Nico faced in college are well on their way to getting fixed. Remember, Nico was just 18 years old last season because he reclassified into the 2019 class. He was one of the youngest players in college basketball, and thus, he was far from a finished prospect. It is no surprise that an 18-year-old would be too skinny, and as we've seen, Nico has already began to add muscle to his frame, which will allow him to create his shot much more easily. He also just so happens to be playing in the perfect system in Golden State, which will allow him to run in transition as much as possible, something that definitely plays to his strengths. And as for his shooting, a lot of times college players just simply have small sample sizes when it comes to things like three-point shooting, as someone like Nico only plays in 32 games in a season. It is very common when evaluating a prospect to look at their free throw shooting as a future indicator of their NBA shooting potential, and Nico's free throw shooting was solid as he shot around 80%. This to me is certainly promising, especially when you combine the fact that he was a knockdown shooter in high school, and recently Nico himself addressed his shooting as well. He said, quote, "I don't think I shot the ball as well as I should have or could have at Arizona. And right now, I'm shooting the ball better than I ever have." He would continue on with, "I think a big thing also is the system that Golden State plays. I think I'll be able to fit right in with that." The team that drafts a player is always incredibly important. It can make or break a player's first few seasons, which is why it is awesome that the Warriors are the perfect situation for Nico. He is going to be able to run in transition. He is going to be able to learn from Steph Curry, a man who was once his idol when Nico attended his camp, and now is going to be the perfect veteran leader for Nico to learn from. And guys, I do want to stress this. Remember, at the end of the day, all of his life, Nico Mannion was seen as a top player in his class. He was supposed to be a top 10 pick headed into last season, and yes, he struggled, and yes, not everyone always pans out, but that does not mean that the talent is not there. You cannot teach the basketball IQ that Nico has. You cannot teach his court vision, and you cannot teach his work ethic. Nico is a player who is going to bust his ass to get better each and every day, and he has already stated that he has a chip on his shoulder with the quote, "Of course, I'm happy I got drafted, especially by the Warriors. Still, there's a chip on my shoulder just because I know there's 29 teams that passed on me. It's something I won't lose." When you combine God-given talent with a relentless work ethic, great things tend to happen, and we can certainly see Nico rise up and have everyone asking, how did this guy possibly fall into the second round? He for sure has the potential to be the steal of this draft, and if you don't believe me, well, let's listen to what Warriors legend Chris Mullin has to say, as after Nico was picked, Mullin proclaimed, "He's a much better shooter than his numbers show. Tough kid, athletic. I've seen some clips of him in the gym. If you have talent and you work hard, you'll get better. All indications are that's what he's all about. He's a gym rat. I think he'll be able to play some backup minutes. I really do. I think it's a great pick." Those are some big words from a Hall of Famer, but I believe Nico can live up to them, and I cannot wait to see how his NBA career progresses. So there we have it, guys. Thank you for watching today's video, and I want to know right now, what do you think about Nico Mannion? Do you think he can be a steal, or do you think he's just going to be another second round pick? Also, as always, if you are new to my channel, make sure to subscribe so you never...
Man, I think, well, that's the end of the video, man. My true thoughts on Nico, bro, to be honest, I just want to see what he does. I want to see how he plays. I want to see what he can do, to be honest. Especially since the Warriors, you know, have a few bad seasons ahead of them, you know, a few bad seasons, you feel me? Sucks to suck, all the Warriors fans. That's you know, you feel me? Can't wait to see what Flight has to say about him, to be honest. But anyways, y'all, there's some videos on the screen, bro. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. Links to my Twitch and my poetry channel are in the description, man. You feel me? With that being said, I'll see you next time, bro. Peace.